10 seconds remaining. Radiant team banned. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Complexities turn to bad. Radiant team pick. Complexities turn to pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Complexities turn to pick.
Welcome back, everybody. It's game number two now between OG and Complexity. The draft is already here, so we're going to jump into it as soon as possible because, Ben, we have an Earth Spirit once again for OG, so we've got that high-impact support that we talked about was kind of lacking for Complexity. So what do you want to see from Cole that will allow Z-Freak to match Crit's impact? Because it's not that they don't have the players to be able to have a really high impact games like Crit does. Z-Freak is probably one of the best, if not the best, support player coming out of
Bounty or Doom, I think, are particularly good on him. Or Enchantress. Enchantress is a little bit more risky, especially when OG so commonly pick up the Crystal Maiden. I like the first phase pickup for them, for the Crystal Maiden, because it's likely going to be banned in the second, and Complexity immediately banned one of the heroes that they saw last game. Juggernaut, very good versus Lifestealer, very good against Enchantress as well, so kind of a no-brainer there for Complexity, but OG, very smart in the draft, and they always seem to nab an Earth Spirit or something better.
Crystal Maiden, Earth Spirit. Once again. I don't know, you can rage out of Crystal Maiden. It's just like, sometimes I see like, I just don't like Crystal Maiden here in certain situations.
It's,
it's really good.
It's to make them fight ready.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it's not for the Frostbite. It's like, they are always fight ready and they have such little downtime in between Skirmish 1 and Skirmish 2 that something is going to be off for Complexity. You combine that with like Wands and the other sustain from their teammates, and like they just have a little bit more HP, a little bit more mana, like, you know, one more level on you, and with their level of execution, they almost always will beat you out of teamfights.
Well, they've also got the counter to the Enchantress, and so our Inch is going to have a little bit more difficult time when it comes to roaming into wherever the Crystal Maiden is. We see our second round of bans, Complexity. Gonna make sure that OG don't get the same kind of sustain that they did last time. Miracle's Juggernaut, as well as banning away the Faceless Void while OG take out the Slardar, the great combination hero with Lifestealer. Like, that is probably one of the better duos in this current patch.
This patch, still pretty good, but not as good. And so they're trying to protect the Lifestealer with the Faceless Void Bam.
And there goes the Alchemist. Gee. Are you thinking that was going to be a third pick for Complexity? Not really feeling it themselves. Lifestealer's a pretty good person.
Is he?
I don't think he starts getting armor,
not without
issues, but
Lightsaber does well against high HP heroes, not high regen heroes. So Alchemist has low HP, high regen, so he can't feast that well.
But Lightsaber is also a bursting hero, which is typically good against heroes that want to be able to draw things out with regen.
Yeah.
I think it's like the Lifestealer is good versus Alchemist in the first 20 minutes of the game. Then, like, Alchemist starts getting more armor, and it's harder and harder to pop. Then his sustain starts taking
OG ban Alchemist, so it'd be Lifestealer and Alchemist on the same.
Yeah. I'm saying OG, like, they wouldn't want it for themselves against Lifestealer.
Oh. So. Yeah.
Disruptor. Bandwidth are picked up by Complexity. That was one of the better supports. This time around, they will have some heavy control. Still not a whole lot of hard stuns, but they will have some disables that stop Bear and Crystal Maiden from falling out of control.
They have much better early game. Enchantress Disruptor is just completely different from the duo of the Wisp plus Oracle that we saw last game. Both those heroes just kind of have to sit in lane or stack. You cannot venture to the opposite side of the river because you can't do anything. And these two heroes are like way different in that aspect, especially Enchantress. At level 1, pick up those newts and ruin all the opponent's lanes. Especially when you have a self-sufficient core like Lifestealer.
Right.
The OG, they still need a solution to deal with Lifestealer. Something anti-BKB is especially good. Bane is a common pickup, but they already have both of their supports. Slardar is also a good pickup versus Lifestealer, but already been taken out. What other things are good? It seems Slark sometimes, but it seems too slow for OG's style of play.
And Disruptor's okay versus Slark, right? So that also might inhibit that pick a bit. They're gonna try and keep things as open as possible. They're gonna go Batrider now.
Batrider is really good versus Enchantress on top of being good against Lifestealer. He's really good against Enchantress because Enchantress can't kite. Like, she needs to run around and fight so she can get maximum damage from Impetus. But if you can't turn, you're not gonna do that much damage with your Impetus. So it doesn't really matter if she gets too farmed or not. Because Enchantresses rarely get BKB. And it's also good because he's a very strong laner. You want a strong offlaner versus Disruptor because Disruptor is not particularly good at zoning out a solo offlaner. And if you have an Enchantress, you're usually just going to be in a safe lane, 2-on-1.
What about Invoker for OG?
I don't really think you can go wrong with Invoker on OG.
I feel like it's one of the better mids versus Lifestealer because all the kiting potential that you have. It's one of the last carry mids that's left for a Miracle to take. The mid against what is now going to be a Death Prophet for Complexity. So they've got the frontliner. Don't have a saving support necessarily, but hopefully the Lifestealer and the natural disables of Disruptor will be able to create the space for the DP.
There you go. Nice burst combo with the Batrider as well.
Absolutely. If they go an Exor combo, the Earth Spirit, like his roaming potential, it's just amped up, right? Because he's now got he rolls in on somebody, guarantees a Sunstrike.
But what about the No-Tail hero? Lycan, I think, is actually pretty good.
Lycan, and they could go Exor, Nav Forger, or maybe Quaswex is better here.
They still run Drow Ranger too. Drow Ranger is also pretty decent.
Yeah, they could. That would definitely allow Invoker to win the match against Death Prophet, I think.
And their Polonk Blitz.
10 seconds remaining.
Because they're liking that hero that can hit towers. Last game it was Alchemist and Jug.
I think you needed a Blink hero, right, for Complexity. Reserve time. I'm gonna go back to the Tidehunter. Picked up last time.
Tidehunter, I think, is really good for Sir Lionel. I think it's...
Oh, Terrorblade! Another one. Another Terrorblade it is! And it gives them... It's kind of like a Lycan, right? Except for, I think it's a bit better at threatening Lifestealer and Death Prophet, because the physical damage is so overwhelming that those heroes can get rather quickly. The Sunder is very applicable to both these heroes as well. I really like this pickup a lot from OG. Now I think...
They have no save for him, though. I think that's...
Ugh. Undying Enchantress aggro duel?
Nothing wrong with Undying. I think Undying's kind of underpicked. And yeah, teams don't pick him a lot, but versus like Terrorblade, 1 decay, he's at like 400 HP at level 1. And I guess like hit him with one impetus and he could die. But
one impetus at level 1.
Potentially. Maybe.
It's a really bad game for No Tail if Enchantress is level 6 and it's still level 1. Well, we'll see how this is going to work for him. Swindles is actually going to be the one playing the Enchantress, so it's a core Enchantress with Z-Freak backing him up the bottom lane. They still have to deal with the Crystal Maiden taking away the creep, but they could definitely put pressure on the Terrorblades.
5 seconds remaining. Undying got buffed, too.
Who?
Undying.
What, did he get buffed?
I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure he got buffed a little bit. I can double check.
Google.
Alright, our typical early TD's out.
Okay, I got it. Intelligence gain increased from 2.5 to 2.8.
Yeah.
Decay cast range increased from 625 to 650. Decay duration increased from 40 to 45. Three buffs.
I like that cast range increase.
I like the increase. I don't have to go arcane every game on him. Although it's probably still not that bad. But that combined with like the base mana buff, which came out after we saw
a lot. Sure.
You think? But Undying, it is set. The Dirgeful Overlord. Name is Dirge the Undying. Kind of redundant. I am Dirge the Dirgeful Overlord.
I believe Dota 2 is...
I don't think so.
Speaking of Dota 1.
You don't see like many Dota 1 names in their items. Spear of I don't even know how you say her name. Ayusa or something? A-I-U, I don't know. You know her Dota 1 name?
No.
Enchantress?
Absolutely not.
Very difficult to pronounce. Anyways.
I avoided all micro heroes in Dota 1.
Oh.
I was not a Warcraft 3 player, if you can't tell.
You can just right click with Impetus. You don't need a micro creeps.
I played Warcraft 3 and cheese people with like Borg tower rushing and stuff. I didn't play real Warcraft. Crow, it wasn't my.
So 500 HP on Terrorblade. Tracks okay. For strength. You are sitting at
420.
420.
Oh,
yeah,
thank
you.
Man.
They changed the strength. I was like 19, 20. 420. One impetus.
one impetus.
One impetus.
Alright, we'll see how much the supports are going to be able to do here to stop this aggression from Complexity. It looks like No Tail's idea is very early Metamorphosis, and that's probably the right idea considering how much Complexity want to right click him while he's still level 1. Plus, it'll give a little bit of time for Earth Spirit to get like his level 2, which is kind of needed. Meanwhile, at the top lane, we do have the Batrider matched up against a Disruptor and Lifestealer. This is not going to be the easiest lane in the world. Back over the bottom, Z-Freak is going to be in some serious trouble. Almost going to be taken out here. The Sunstrike going to come in. Is not going to land. Z-Freak almost going down. Just 10 HP is all that's left. He does manage to survive and will shamble his way off to the fountain. Crit's going to take a lot of return damage.
He's see terribly HP.
Some free space.
340. Oh, man.
This is just value for the tangos, Ben.
Z-Freak, decay stack's wearing off, but you know, he's not the worst hero to go back and heal. Ideally, you dump your mana before you go, but
yeah,
you know, you gotta go heal when you gotta go heal. Crit.
With Philosophy of Life, the top lane, they're gonna start going on to Moon. They get lead with the open wounds, get a lot of damage from the Thunderstrike as well. It's not going to be enough, though. Moon does seem to be doing pretty well in this lane.
Yeah, that's... This is a really good lane for him.
Maybe like level 3 or level 4, they might have kill potential with the lockdown of Hanskin plus the rage, but Moon is punishing them here at level 1, but he may just have gone a bit too far. They pop the rage, trying to finish him off, but Miracle's actually going to get the first blood at bottom lane. Looks like they're fighting that one out. Managed to get the Death Prophet roll in from the Earth Spirit on mid. We're trying to follow that top lane.
That's fun. Dealing with our spirit room.
Yep.
Still, Invoker is out of mana, so not any kill threat coming out from him. Z-Freak not doing the best job of pressuring No-Tail because he is sitting at the top of the CS board at 14, whopping CS.
And Metamorphosis is about to come back up.
Well, that won't matter if he doesn't have any HP.
Well, the damage reduction is definitely getting a lot of work out here. That poor man shield. Yeah, I mean, there's like the downside of the Enchantress, right? You're running an Enchantress offlane, but you don't have a creep that you can use.
If they had more magic first in this lane, it'd
yeah.
be
sick.
It like
really would.
Timbersaw. Like one Whirling Death could take him down a lot and also impair his last thing abilities, but hey, right now Swindle's just kind of like tickles.
Oh, Lip, you're too far forward. He's gonna get caught again, get kicked back into the tier one. He has the double spirit siphon, but that's just not gonna be enough to out heal.
As OG picks up yet another kill, the Earth Spirit free to roam into mid constantly since the bottom lane is just not being able to put enough pressure on this Terrorblade.
They need more levels on Z-Freak so he can pump out more decays.
Moon gonna be gone on once again. This time he is dead. I will watch you die, Moon Meander.
You're making me miss First Blood earlier.
Swindle's getting a lot of CS on his bottom lane. And he actually goes for the row with a Magi first to hurt No-Tail a little bit more with his spears. He is throwing spears like constantly at him, and No-Tail still has a salve and a tango.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
It's a poor man's shield. A workout. Aestrin, Miracle, get some damage on the limb. Nothing major will come of it. Roll in. Nice sidestep there from Z-Freak. Now Crit is actually pretty far forward. Will be able to get the kick back through Z-Freak. He does have the decay, also the heal, but that's not going to allow him to survive long enough. If he gets hit by the Frostbite, his escape is being covered. Crit trying to go for the body blocks, allowing more space for No-Tail to get those right clicks to finish him off.
Yeah, this lane's a disaster.
Certainly is. Complexity's laning phase not going nearly as well as it did at game number one.
Maybe Inlaying needs a few more buffs.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe don't run Undying Enchantress. Against a lane that can't stop you.
Maybe what they should have done is put the Enchantress in the jungle to get more levels, but a lot of that was countered by the first phase Crystal Maiden, because then Enchantress can't really jungle. If you get her in the jungle early and Undying can get level 3, I think they could do a lot more damage in this lane, but they're just sharing XP, and Undying finally hit level 3, but now Terrorblade already has a few kills under his belt, and a lot of CS, and it's just not as effective when...
Oh, they're gonna try and go for the... He's got a lot of levels of Soul Rip. No-Tail, you gotta be careful, homie! Oh, Jesus. The healing salve is gonna be able to keep him alive. They're now gonna turn and try and fight Crit instead. Can't get the block, though. Crit manages to bolt his way through the trees to safety. And while Complexity do try and take some control of this lane, they didn't get the kill they really wanted. No-Tail going back underneath this tier 1, not really caring. Z-Freak with no levels of Tombstone since went for the max magic damage. Ponskin will be able to get the glimpse back. Nice pick. They finally get a kill here. This bottom lane.
A lot of commitment.
You're not going to be able to challenge for that that rune, Miracle. Illusion. Again, trying to save the Bounty Rune at bottom, so we have to fill up the bottle. Z-Freak, you do not have boots yet. Slowed down by the reflection, kicked back once again by Crit. He will be able to get the double soul rip. They also have on the side, they're going to be able to catch Moon here with the exorcism. Z-Freak barely able to survive. They now turn to cutting behind the tier 1 tower. They're going to get fly. Us OG start massive rotating. Yeah, there's no way. Miracle's not going to rotate through. No-Tail hiding himself in the trees. Hanskin almost dying to this tower, almost gets kicked, but he managed to stay ahead of that one, and Crit rolls right through all of these heroes. No-Tail, he's going to fight this one out. The Sunstrike almost lands on Hanskin, but it doesn't even matter. They don't need it. Complexity. Dive in the tier 1 tower needlessly, searching for kills and staying way too long.
And as you mentioned, Death Prophet really struggling in the armor department. Terrorblade, 150 damage on that low armor Death Prophet, and combine that with the surprise Sunstrike from Invoker, and now OG are in a firm position in this early game after applying that push.
Died again. Sunstrike. Just in time.
When are they going to abandon this bottom lane? They keep seeming to throw bodies at that. They really wanted to slow down No-Tail's farm, but
it's just not happening. Certainly not. Moon
showing himself in mid, clearing through the creep wave, giving the space for Miracle to be able to take the tier 1 without threat of denying. Crit is going to try and come in and punish Lim for trying to go for the deny, and they've got him too. They managed to get the soul rip off and then heals him a little bit, but it's just not enough. Moon, unfortunately, his Firefly doesn't last long enough for him to get out of the trees. Chesty will get the turnaround kill, but it's still to OG's favor overall.
Still spent his gold, and Miracle, well on his way to a very early Midas. Lifestealer not been able to get involved in too many of these fights. Complexity needs him to, especially with Undying falling off so quickly with no boots. Z-Freak, need that move speed, man.
Tail is now level 7, even though he doesn't have it. Complexity now got to start thinking about the threat of the Sunder. And unless they have Static Storm, they don't really have anything to stop him from getting that off. Not enough hard disables. They have the Death Prophet Silence eventually as well. Overall, game number one, it was nice for Complexity because the laning phase was well set up for them to win, and they still ended up losing that game by... they lost control by like 20 minutes, you'd say. Here, in this game number two, where Complexity have lost the laning phase, you really gotta wonder if they're gonna be able to pull it back at all.
You have Death Prophet, who is surprisingly strong in teamfights. They do have the Undying heal and Tombstone to protect her in teamfights. So there is still that potential where Exorcism can just crush 3 or 4 heroes, especially if she builds a little bit more armor so she's tanky. Or HP, either or. I still like the Veil build. I don't know why that fell out of favor so quickly.
Yeah, I think especially against all this damage being run around by OG. Miracle's just doing the efficient round of sitting on top of the Ancients while his team pushes out the top lane and trades tier 1.
So Complexity can actually do Roche very early. It would be very slow. They don't use Exorcism, but they could definitely do it with level 4 Untouchable. No minus armor on the Lifestealer, no Blightstone on him. Medallion coming out, so that would be a very long road.
I think they need it though. I think they should use the Exorcism.
I don't think they're in that desperate of a position yet.
You don't think so? I'm kind of feeling it right now.
If they fight in the pit...
they're 3k behind already.
If they fight in the pit and they get magnetized, they will all die. And you have to deal with Napalm and just Batrider. That general air is not a good idea. Like, that's just almost a guaranteed loss if you lose the fight, as opposed to, hey, we can still win a fight with Exorcism, with Static Storm once we get our tomes up, and maybe this is the start.
See, I'm just not convinced that they should go for the 5-man fight, because they don't have level 6 on Disruptor yet. But they do get the Glimpse, and a pickoff on Moon will give them the opening, that's for sure. Throws out the Lasso, because why the hell not, but... he is going to die ultimately, and now Complexity can go for the tier 1.
Underestimate Complexity's team fight.
Yeah, well, I mean, you get a pickoff like that. It's a real easy tier 1 with the Exorcism.
And Arcane Rune. On Death Prophet, especially.
Oh, nice.
Are they even going to get this tower? Moon's already respawning. Jeez, he's only level 6, what happened? He's 0-4.
Yeah, he was supposed to have such a great time at that top lane, remember?
He was! Then... started feeding.
Started meandering about.
In the wrong place.
All the wrong places. Well, they do get the tier 1 after all. G not trying to challenge them for it. Then, no tail. Trying to go for the tier 2 at top lane, and he's almost got it too. Dragonlance already. Three-man smoke. They desperately need a pickoff just to be able to get Moon some gold so we can work in towards that Blink Dagger. They'll get some gold off of this tier 2 though. No-Tail's still able to take it.
And nice damage. Line draw from Hanskin. He knows exactly where they're going to go, and Z-Freak still is going to die at the end of the day. He does manage to buy his treads right before he dies.
What was he doing? He wasn't going to stop Terrorblade from pushing that.
He's just desperate because he doesn't have a place to go.
Aren't we all a little desperate?
Not as desperate as Z-Freak in this situation.
You know, I tried to give Z-Freak a compliment in the start of this cast. Probably very much over-exaggerated that compliment. Look the way he's treating it.
It happens.
Not getting his laning phase 1.
They did pick him Undying. So if he played if he played decently, you'd be like, wow, Z-Freak's really good. But because like this, you're just like, ah, it's just Undying.
just undying things, really.
Miracle going for BOT's build. And looking to avoid the team fight, maybe even buying more time for Batrider to maybe get his Blink Dagger, just needs 500 more gold. And overall, OG, they are in a really good position because they don't have to force team fights against Complexity.
Yeah. I mean, it's just the classic pushing carry with Invoker, right? Anytime you have that, you're going to try and pick up Boots of Travel. You can have the pushing carry on one side, the Invoker on the other, and push to your heart's content.
While getting pickoffs with the Sunstrike.
Yeah. Because, yeah, that's the thing about it, right? Is that spreading out the hero so much and split pushing does force Complexity to move apart. Opportunities like this present themselves. Moon turns around, still has the lasso. He's waiting and waiting and waiting until the rage kind of wears itself out. Chessy now making a break for the infest on the creep. He'll be able to get inside a range creep. Still going to be trying to chase down. Looks like they're having a bot lane fight. We'll go follow fight Chessy as he's going to be slowed down by the refraction. A rage TP out, but oh, the metamorphosis for No Tail, and he just creams it. Meanwhile, bottom lane, what the hell happened here? It's a bloodbath.
Limp picked up Miracle. Disruptor killed Earth Spirit. Well, I was watching top. I was hoping for the Sip Armlet toggle coming out from him while he was TPing. Did not happen.
Well, either way, they've got the tier 2 in hand, it seems.
I don't know. Exorcism is almost down.
Yeah, it's not gonna be good enough.
So it's a big kill onto Invoker. And looks like Moon will finally get the space that he needs from his Blink Dagger. If he's going Blink. At this point, I'm pretty sure he's getting Blink. He hasn't bought any components of the drums aside from the place.
15-minute Blink Dagger. Not the latest in the world.
Not so either. Bad. They have enough burst to kill DP. Yes, they do. Unless Disruptor gets a good ultimate. Oh, he picked up a lot of levels off that. And Tombstone into the Patience. This Tombstone is not going to last long enough, or is it?
Yeah, it's taken them so long to farm this, but it is very safe farm. OG are going to try and cut across with their smoke. They do have the successful scan. You know some of these heroes are here. The Tombstone's going to wear out, and many of these heroes are quite low, so this can actually turn really nasty. There's no invest now. They jump in, manage to get the lasso fly, hoping to be able to get a good freezing field. It's blocked out by the static storm for a little bit. Now drops it, but it's a bit too late. Chessy now pops the rage, and they finish off Moon. A turnaround kill at the bare minimum. In fact, it's not just going to be one, it looks like almost two. Fly slowed down by the Spirit Siphon. Unable to get the glimpse on him, though. Hanskin loses vision. Seems like the team get out.
That was a really quick Static Storm coming out from Hanskin right there that definitely saved the fight. And not the greatest coordination on the lasso and the Sunstrike. And at the end of the day, they only killed the Undying with that Blink reveal. Good. Not good at all.
Look who else has got a Blink Dagger, though. Crit. The real third core. What's he can do now in these fights with the Blinkin and Magnetize. Meanwhile, Miracle or No Tail are just doing their split pushing things.
Yeah, they're still taking pretty heavy casualties around the map, especially on the Invoker on the bottom lane. That was one of the bigger kills that's happened in this game. However, Limp is falling very far behind Chessy is falling pretty far behind even with the help of the Ancients. And now heading to Roche, they do have Exorcism up, and it's going to be really slow if they don't use it, so I think they have to.
Yeah, just because otherwise there's going to be too much given to the top lane. This Miracle's not actually going to be pushing it right now, he's playing it a little bit more conservatively. So Complexity slow Roshan attempts may pay out.
I don't know. They're sending in the illusions right now. It will scout them out. It's at about 30%. And OG are quick to get over there. They do have a smoke on Crystal Maiden. Is it time?
All right, well, Lin pops the regen.
He's gonna pop this exorcism as soon as he's got the mana for it. He knows they are desperate for time, as Crit's gonna jump in looking for the magnetized opportunity. He's gonna be able to get eaten up almost immediately by Jesse, but Limp is being targeted on by No-Tail so damn quickly they can't do anything about it. The Saturn Storm goes out, but Jesse, the damage is already done. He's off of the cliff and they can't bring him back down. He's got the Infest. Oh, Terrorblade stashed it! Got the Aegis. Seafree couldn't stop that one. Someone give this man a lift. Jesse needs an Infest out, but can't actually reach anybody, so he's just a sitting duck. Manages to finally get the Infest inside. Z-Freak will be able to get himself away. Meanwhile, Swindle starts tanking up No-Tail. Actually, oh god, not enough.
Okay, and Miracle.
Sunstrike, ooh! Oh, but he gets slow. Rage, Jesse. Be able to arm the toggle. Meanwhile, Miracle's doing Miracle things. Top lane, he's already taken a tier 3, and these heroes are going to be low enough that they can't actually fight yet. Miracle's just going to take a lane of Rex. Maybe. We'll see. DP in for the Death Prophet. Miracle will have to back himself away now. But
what a 500 fight HP. By No-Tail. Taking the Roshan to kill and stealing the Aegis. There was a lot of units inside the pit. There were like 20 zombies, I want to say. All stacked up around and still managing to get the last hit and click on the Aegis through that is quite miraculous. Nice lasso by Batrider. Nice infest by the Life Stealer to pop himself out there.
But
the
trick. That wasn't nice.
Complexity can't be happy with that fight at all.
No, sure not.
Pulling the 8-bone exorcism. Now Limp's gonna be caught out. He's actually very, very dead. Even if Limp somehow managed to get some distance, the Miracle just picked up Yule Scepter, so he still had the Yule Scepter and Sunstrike bow.
That's a hefty amount of damage, especially with that drums charge being used and complexity. Yeah, now their early game didn't go well, even with an Undying. They've lost a couple team fights even with the Death Prophet. I don't want to say all in for the Rosh, but they committed pretty heavily to that, and it looks like Z-Freak might take a spill in the mid lane. That's a dead zombie.
Isn't that competitive? No-Tail needs to be able to get off a good send here, but nice play from Jesse with the Infest to dodge the Sunder and get the additional burst damage. Now they're going to be able to pull back Moon, manage to get the Static Storm on top of him.
Wow.
Two kills.
That was sick from Jesse.
Yeah, dang. Can they get a third one? They're chasing. They have to be careful. Well, Miracle's going to push out the bottom lane. Trying to catch up the Fly here. They've almost got the Glimpse in hand. Nice double kick. These heroes now have to stay outside of vision of Hanskin. We'll be able to get a little bit. Crit managed to get the Silence, hoping to be able to get the roll away outside of the range of Glimpse, and not quite there. Pulled back in, taken out by Complexity. Miracle's now here, though. They gotta be careful with him. Hanskin, he's definitely dead. And they fight Miracle, though. Miracle gets off the Invis. They've got the counter ward laid down. They've almost got the vision. They do just enough. And Complexity turned this game around pretty quickly. They've got the Rage. Can he eat through Fly? Not fast enough.
Nice entry placement. TP himself right before, away. Right before the death. That was really important by Disruptor.
Yeah. Good call by Hanskin.
And all of that started with a great Infest coming out from Jesse.
Yeah.
Moon just has not had that big of an impact on Batrider in this game. He's just eating a lot.
Well, the Scotty's now complete. Even though it feels like very similar to game number one, where Complexity are doing some okay things in team fights, and you're like, oh, look, they just won this little fight, but it's just like time is against them. And this game, as it goes later and later, I mean, No-Tail has a Scotty by 21 minutes.
I don't think it's
Boker is level 16.
That bad. Chantress is surprisingly farmed. She can also steal Terrorblade's illusions, and he doesn't have a Manta style, so he can't have that many illusions up. Undying, I think, is the biggest problem here, in that he's just kind of useless.
I mean, isn't both Terrorblade and Invoker higher impact mid late game than Lifestealer?
Yeah, but Death Prophet's better at team fights, and if they get the right burst, which they have a lot of. Drop No-Tail like we just saw.
Moon looking for its initiation. Chessie already down to half HP, pops the rage, tries to man fight up against No-Tail, will be able to get a soul rip, heal pops out, will be able to get a silence on No-Tail, so no Sunder once again. Complexity, Spirit Siphon onto two, slowing them down, fly, goes for the freezing field, not going to be good enough to get a turnaround kill. Moon is trying to slow down these heroes with his sticky napalm, but he's got to be careful to get the hell out of here, because there is nothing they can do.
He really needed a Manta over the...
Oh, double kick? They know the Lifestealer is in here, so they're going to try and abuse Complexity. But Limp leads with the Yule Scepter, will be able to follow up. Tornado is the free escape from Miracle as he runs himself away.
Yeah, he really needed the Manta over the Scotty there, because he just sat in silence, could not pull off the Sunder.
Yeah.
And that is a really big deal in the teamfight, especially when you could have used it on a high priority hero like the Lifestealer in that fight. Well, he was kind of low, so maybe not him.
Kick onto Limp, silence, Sunstrike, popped him!
Ooh. Indeed. Yeah, Miracle's getting ridiculous at the farm.
Channel.
I just don't see Complexity being able to get that many good picks, though. The last really good engagement for them was just Chain Feed. First, No-Tail Death, and then another Glimpse, and then Boker trying to finish someone off. It was just like an unfortunate series of events for OG, where it could have easily gone like he gets a Sunder off and then Complexity have to all turn tail and run. So if fights just go pretty decently for OG, they should be able to win it with their massive farm advantage and their massive split advantage with the Invoker with the BOTs.
Chessie is many, he's actually hasn't gotten that many kills. One kill, 11 assists. Oh, he seems to be a bit unlucky when it comes to claiming the last hit. Maybe
he's
that's why his farm is rather slowed down compared to the farms of the...
He has the front line, which is much different than the way OG's lineup works. And front line for Swindles at this point, who is dishing out a lot of damage with that Dragonlance plus Ags, and maybe soon enough like a Moonshot or whatever he may want.
Yeah, if he gets level 3 Impetus and gets some attack speed on him, that is a glass cannon. Might be able to threaten the Terrorblade pretty well.
Terrorblade doesn't have the greatest attack speed. Except with this bit.
Woke up, they're gonna grab Chessie. No rage here, so Chessie in some serious trouble. They managed to get the Static Storm. Chessie still silenced self, though. Not gonna be able to do anything there. No-Tail fights up a limb, trying to get the Sunder off as the Static Storm faded, but no chance. Big long shot, but it's not enough. The cap is there, and Grit will be able to escape, it seems. The zombie's trying to chase him down, but one for one exchange. Considering the fact that OG were the ones who made the initiation there, that's not too bad for Complexity. It just blew the exorcism, which kind of sucks.
Well, they can't control the Death Prop in these fights. They have to use a lot to control the Lifestealer. And at the same time, they are constantly getting kills in Terrorblade. I guess you just might need BKB at this point. Screw the Manta. Not getting any Sunders off in these fights and just can't dish out enough damage. Maybe a Glimmer Cape would really help on the side of OG, but I haven't really seen it put to good use.
Hanskin running for help, but Z-Free can't save him. Sorry, my friends. Nothing I can do here. And maybe another pick off Miracle. Setting up his abilities to go for Tornado and Meteor if he wants to. Tornado is on Z-Freak. They do have backup though, very rapidly. Both Limp and Chessie are going to be here. They get the Sun Silence, but that's not going to be enough. Miracle, there's now no interrupt to be able to save him here. As long as they have the counter vision, they've got him dead to rights. Complexity go for more. Well, I'm gonna go for the Glimmer Cape. TP out will be successful. Moon Meander. Nothing to be done here.
Complexity. Very careless play by OG
the
past
no.
few minutes.
Look for Roshan, but it's not up. It's about to be. Sit inside the pit, it's all good. Maybe they get Moon. Has to blink himself out of this one to the side. TP away, it's good. And Roshan is now.
Yeah, no creep from Swindles to scout that one out. Bryce D hasn't thrown one in there yet. Fly pings it out immediately, knowing that it is a threat. And without Sunstrike there,
They have to send a Terrorblade Illusion to scatter out immediately. However, Hanskin, is he going to throw a kinetic field inside of there? Not look
do
like
it. Hanskin, no. Yeah.
They are missing out. And Wimp, with his exorcism, finally cooled down. But he will see a Terrorblade Illusion. And man, that might be enough to dissuade him from taking it.
Got exorcism in 10 seconds. Do you think they could have YOLO'd it real quickly?
That is pretty YOLO. Again, they're fighting in there without BKBs. Earth Spirit wrecked them last time. What's to stop them doing the same thing again?
And I guess the Invoker, it wouldn't take him very long to get there thanks to Boots of Travel and max movement speed.
And Miracle trying to draw them away from the pit with some pressure on the top lane. Waiting for his VOTs to cool down. Complexity do have pretty good fight around the pick, but it takes longer for them to set up. You need to dish out damage with the exorcism. You need time to dish out the zombies from Undying on the high ground.
Somebody help the top lane. That range tracks drops pretty quickly against Horde Spirits with Alacrity on them. Complexity need to take better care of that top lane maintenance.
What is No-Till spent gold on? About something.
I'm not sure, but Swindles is dead. I think so. Maybe not. Chessie actually managed to get the open wounds on Moon. Now he's in trouble. Pops the Ghost Scepter, but will still be glimpsed back. Unfortunately, it's on the other side of the cliff. That actually allows him to be able to continue his escape. Tier. They're going to go back to top lane, but of course, Miracle, he's just showing and will be able to wex his way out of there.
It did reveal the ward though with that. That was, I don't know, a dubious flame break. And,
but if he created enough space for No-Till to take Roshan before Complexity can rotate over, it's all worth it.
Yep, they're all heading there as fast as they can with smoke.
They got damage.
Yep, that's already at half HP. And Alacrity on top of that. Look at his damage. Oh my goodness.
Yeah,
about that.
Smoke up. Oh no, Chessie, look out! He's not going through the wall. One, they get the Static Storm. He managed to get a DFS. Not staying alive though, and No-Till manning up through all of it. He still has the Aegis. Gets off the Sunder as well. This fight is over for Complexity. They're still going to try and fight it out with that ultimate of limbs, but it's not going to be good enough. Freezing Field finishes them off as now No-Till comes back with his second life. They start slowing down the last hero. Z-Freak will not be able to TP out. Yul Scepter and Flame Break both ready to stop that. Attempt at an escape, and Complexity lose four in Aegis.
How many times have we seen DD at Roche, just like at the perfect time? It seems far too common. It's crazy.
It really is. Well, now, OG from that double damage get Roshan fast enough that Roshan leads to them winning a fight, and that fight now leads to them taking a late Rax. Maybe even two with the way they're ripping through these buildings. No-Till, yeah, he's already setting up for two.
With no exorcism, Complexity just really do not have that much fight left in them. Their spirit's probably broken after Terrorblade got that Sunder off at that last fight.
The illusion's pushing in. OG back up. They're going to play it safe. The Lincoln's ready to go for the Invoker, so now he doesn't even care all that much. Getting caught out by the glimpse. That's like the only single target ability worth mentioning, right? Yul Scepter, I guess, from Limp.
Open wounds?
Open wounds, yeah, I guess.
Yul's, I think, is actually kind of big.
Mm-hmm.
So they can stop his Blink Dagger.
Okay. Moon. Doing typical Neva Eva things. Or staffs himself into the enemy, blinks back. Show confidence from the OG offlaner. Chessie managed to get the open wounds on Miracle, but similarly, able to stay out of the hands of Complexity. Blink Dagger.
Yeah, I think the Lincoln's pickup is like for the Yul setup. If they Yul's him, he can't blink out, which is a really big deal because he needs to be able to keep distance away from the Death Prophet and the Life Stealer.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Decent. Four step would also be pretty good, but they do not have one on Batrider.
They need, like, Diffuse a Blade on something.
I don't know. He's having a hard time staying alive.
Yeah.
Last time was with the DD, but even without the DD, I still think he's going to get trucked.
Swindle's glass cannon gets shattered here.
OG drops lasso and fly drops to the ground with the freezing fields.
Let it ride, fly. Let it ride.
Now it's going to be left up to the initiation. Lip's going to come in through the side here, but they're just going to be able to burst him down to get the Yule Scepter to dodge that meteor incoming while Chetsy battling it out with No-Tail managed to get off the Sunder, and No-Tail, he gets on the reflection last second, will be able to finish him off. Oh my god, he lived! Three heroes, none of them could finish him off. He gets away, and Complexity now done with this series.
The big bad Terrorblade strikes again. He's been winning a lot of games today. Valiant effort by Complexity. Kind of outclassed by OG, sadly, in this matchup. Yeah. I think their draft this game was a little bit better. Even despite the Undying, which we'll probably consider like bottom 20% of Dota heroes.
All right, well, that is our